thinness and thickness of the lead of pencil can play wonders in playing with textures of paper, scribbling, scumbling, hatching, fine drawing, and even merging of contours. Unlike a standard pencil, one doesn't need to sharpen the lead again and again with mechanical pencils. A very fine line can be easily achieved by mechanical pencils. One can visually imagine the proportions of the figure and then gradually, after catching the contours of the face of the model, defining the silhouette and dark masses and read the depth as precisely as possible. Dark depths across the eyes can easily give an idea in which direction the model is looking. The pressure of the lead can decide the darkness of the line. One can bring out middle and darkest tone at the same go by intricately observing the shadows across the face. After drawing the main characteristics of the facial expressions of the model, one needs to read the placement of the collar of the shirt against the neck. A lighter line can reflect the light shade of the shirt. One just needs to darken the shaded areas. Darken the hair on the head. A little white space on the hair will reflect the shine in the hair. And the darkest part of the neck will be the area touching the color of the shirt. Start drawing the folds of the shirt. This drawing of folds is also a creative process of learning how to see the graphic images selectively. One doesn't need to count to folds to sketch them. One can electively choose the ones which reflect the pose of the model in which he is sitting. Like Vic Muni says, drawing is not only a way to come up with pictures. Drawing is a way to educate your eye to understand visual information, organizing it into a more hierarchical way, a more economical way. When you see something, if you draw often and frequently, you examine a room very differently. After drawing the angle of left leg and the selective folds of the pants, draw the second leg by observing the angle in which it lay down twisted on a side. One needs to be very spontaneous in drawing the creases of the clothing, because if an artist controls his hand more and is too particular, then the rhythm of the lines might break and hinder the beauty of the drawing. Draw a line reflecting the arm, hiding behind the leg and hand and curved in the angle of the arm. Apply a little shading over the arm to make it stand out against the lightness of the shirt. The fingers of the other hand holding the upper arm can be drawn by simplifying the basic shape of fingers in small rectangles, depicting the phalanges. After defining the actual shape and proportions, one can merge the details by shading over the fingers. The observations, practice, and knowledge guides the artist to develop his drawing by darkening and highlighting particular areas. Like Jeff Koons said, drawing is an immediate way of articulating an idea, of making a gesture that is both physical and intellectual. A few rough strokes here and there over the legs will automatically indicate the creases of the jeans, and the darkened parts will hint at the light falling over the clothes. Time to draw the feet of the model. There is a difference in the drawing of the foot placed flat on the ground and the one with its sole visible. The straight one will have angular toe. By shading the heel, one can make out the angular indentation of the foot. In the second foot, which is laying down twisted and the sole visible, the toes will just become small circles. The heel will have a curve in it. It is a totally different drawing and details, which an artist needs to observe. If one is aware of the muscles, tendons, and bone structure, then it's very easy to define a shape, even in shading and a few strokes. Start scribbling in the shaded areas of the flare of the pants, and then let a few lines show the folds on the raised platform on which the model is sitting. Adding middle tone in the upper body of the model by scribbling fine lines over the shirt adds another depth in the drawing. This feeling of touch and add more in a work of art is the craving of explore more. Henri Matisse very aptly expressed, "I want to reach the state of condensation of sensation which constitutes a picture. Perhaps I might be satisfied momentarily with a work finished at one sitting, but I would soon get bored looking at it. Therefore, I prefer to continue working on it so that later I may recognize it as a work of my mind." Thank you. darken the area under the legs and folds of the drapery of the seat. The fine, thin lines of the mechanical pencil helps in creating a wonderful play of delicacies. Spreading it across a wider area is more tedious in comparison to the standard pencil, but the sharpness of lines can be easily retained. Adding dark patches over the toes, darkening the edges of the legs, a few scribbles over the sleeves of the shirt. All this will bring the drawing close to completion. One can easily make out the interplay of scribbles, scumblings, hatching and shading in creating the lightest, middle and darkest color tone. The work of art has a statement to make, but it is the observer who shapes that statement into personal communication by committing himself to the experience. The work can speak to those who are passively involved, but it speaks most eloquently and satisfyingly when it becomes a part of a visual dialogue. The extra touches which an artist is giving to the drawing as final touches may seem very unwanted to a spectator. But for an artist, these strokes of fine lines and dark patches are adding new dimensions to the work, a fusion of senses and intellectual. The second drawing is with a standard pencil. In this, the model is standing with one foot placed a bit higher than ground. Start the drawing by roughly drawing the shape of the face and indications of the facial features. The previous model had a thin, angular and a long facial bone structure. But the present model has a round face. One had a broader forehead and one has flick of hair hiding half forehead. The treatment of pencil also varies. One can see the difference between the sharpness and fineness, of line of the mechanical pencil and a standard one. One needs to be very observant even at an initial stage, as this base will only lead to a strong base for a masterpiece. To express outward form correctly requires a knowledge of the internal structure, that is, of bones which compose the framework and define its proportions, and of the muscles and tendons which direct its action. Every figure artist finds sooner or later as he advances in his artistic career that his work needs strengthening through a well-grounded knowledge of anatomy. An understanding of anatomy is an instrument in mechanics of art. A means to be employed to assist but never allowed to dominate. After a rough analysis of the shape of the face, the placement of features, the character and expression, time has come to draw the shoulders and shirt, leading to the turn of arm and torso. The observation of the folds of the shirt and the angles of the arm and hand with thumb stuck in the pocket of pants. All will indicate the posture of the model. If the initial drawing is done with light lines, then one does not need to erase the unwanted strokes. One can easily cover them up with darker strokes and shading. The sketch will further lead to the angle of the raised leg and the one placed flat on the ground. One needs to be aware of the length variations of different parts of the body, proportions, foreshortening, etc. The exact drawing of the muscles, tendons, and bones is not as crucial as the awareness of the presence of the bones under the visible layer of the skin and clothing. One can easily guess from the appearance of the sketch what a complete drawing would look like. Like Jean-Auguste Ingres said, drawing includes 3.5 quarters of the content of the painting. Drawing contains everything except the hue. Time to start defining the facial features with more details and also hiding the invisible sides in the play of shadows. Draw the angle of the nose, the shape of the eyebrow, and the arc in which it is raised. Like Camille Pissarro aptly said, it is only by drawing often, drawing everything, drawing incessantly, that one fine day you discover to your surprise that you have rendered something in its true character. One needs to know that the upper line of an eye will always be dark, as that only helps in adding depth to an eye. One can also see the contrast of the treatment of a standard pencil and mechanical one in a drawing. As one keeps on using a standard pencil, the lead keeps on losing its sharpness and takes a rounder and wider shape. One can observe the two sketchings being drawn on the same paper with different mediums. Without observing the shape of lips, eyes, ears, and nose, it is very difficult for an artist to bring exact resemblance to the model. Gradually, with practice, mind can guess where to turn the line, where to emphasize, where to shade, and what shape would actually bring out the character of the model. Here the expression of the model can easily be caught by his downward bent mustache. Practice only can strengthen the hold of an artist over the subject. Perceiving the dimensions and exploring the creative strategy of simplification and intricate observation all becomes part of learning process. Delicate shading on under chin area, cheeks, eyes, nose, and a little darker stroke on the side of the face will all build the features step by step. Initially, all these studies appear too restraining to an artist, but gradually B realizes the value of each shape, line, and stroke. An impression of movement can be achieved by series of shapes. None of them needs to be thin, sharp, or linear, but collectively they can suggest sequence, direction, or thrust. Line in general represents the viewer's conclusion, a set of form going somewhere. Similarly, one stroke automatically guides another one, and collective contribution of various lines, scribbles, scumbling leads to a complete look. Start darkening the hair of the model. The direction of the pencil strokes will tell the direction in which hair are combed and shaped. It totally depends on the artist who he wants to treat his subject. With rough strokes, spontaneity, careful lines, delicately, smooth touch, or a coarse look. The dealing or the treatment reflects the mood of the artist. The need of the subject, variety of technique, and nature of the medium being used. A touch at one place will trigger the spirits of the artist to retouch already done area. He makes conscious choice which appear effective for his purpose. And with a series of intuitive decisions, he brings various elements together to form a unified whole. Apply a little dark touches to the eyebrows, chin and under chin area. Shading on the neck will enhance the face more. These might seem like random pencil strokes, but these small touches will help in adding more gravity to the drawing. Look deeply into tonal variations and try to grasp the subtle variations. A few areas might need to be darkened to achieve a balance of the tone. Tonal drawing is simply a balancing act between the elements of light and shade. In fact, all drawing is a constant balance between your observation, your concentration, your judgment, and your technique. Over the time, with practice, one can learn to convert nothing into something. These fluidity of strokes, vitality, skillful doodling, darkening and lightening of creases, all will slowly build a relationship and add meaning in the interrelated spaces. Touch and retouch of the folds of the cloths and features takes the drawing to another higher level, where one can feel the visual dialogue among different elements and dissimilar and similar characteristics. The direction of the lines also indicate the fall of the clothing. Every element will speak its own language, caught in the folds of light and dark. Apply darkness to the eyes and slightly blur of line in the shadows. Then, without breaking the line, stretch the pencil across the arm, as it will make it appear solid and bold. More the broken line, more beauty in a drawing is lost. Little shading here and there across the arm will bring roundness to it and define its shape and placement. Variation of shading only helps in taking the drawing to a next mature level. One needs to study the prominent characteristics, like the way the hand is twisted to be stuck in the pocket of jeans, the holy thread and watch engulfing the wrist, and the curved line of the knuckles. One cannot learn all this in a glance. Observation of shape, sizes, bone structure and muscles is very important to understand any feature or part of the body. Once you start giving outline to the form or folds with pencil, the scribbles and doodling will act as a shadow in the drawing, and gradually all parts will get a concrete shape, with the important details being brought out step by step. John Berger beautifully expressed, "Drawing is a way of coming upon the connection between things, just like metaphor in poetry reconnects what has become separated." Start adding the darkest tone to already prevailing lightest and middle tone of the neck. Darken the edges of the collar and start defining the shape of the legs hidden under the folds of the pants. Keep on scribbling across the creases of the cloth. Mind will calculate the shape and depth even before the final touch. Like David Hockney said, drawing is like rather playing chess. Your mind races ahead of the moves that you eventually make. Mm-hmm. These flowing, rhythmic and bold pencil strokes are reflection of the knowledge and expertise of working with imagination, intuition and precision by arranging and rearranging various elements. Even a few scribbles across the feet and the creases of clothing without much details and just by catching the basic pose in a few rough strokes. Also helps one to visualize the finished form. Form highlighted by shadings and a few projections of lines can make a composition look complete even with minimum details. Draw the line for the drapery which is laying under the feet of the model. It is giving a horizontal gravity to the perpendicular model. Again, add a few darker depths, scumbling or scribbles to the drawing which has taken out a perfect shape. The proportions, the shading, the pose of the model and even the treatment of two different types of pencils is clearly visible now. The dealing totally depends on the artist, his expectation from his drawing and his imagination. Like Auguste Rodin said, the modes of expression of men of genius differs as much as their souls, and it is impossible to say that in some among them, drawing and color are better or worse than in others. The sharper touches with a sharpened lead brings the drawing to its completion.